Thank you all for coming for the middle school orchestra concert. I'm Mr. Gett, in case you don't know who I am, I'm assuming everyone does. I want to thank all of the administrators. Can they all stand up? I'm sorry to do this to everyone. Please, Dr. Hatter, thank you, thank you. Mrs. Howard, thank you. As a teacher, I know them very well. As parents, I know in my children's school, I really wasn't aware, but the administrators, you have no idea how much work they do. I mean, literally, I don't even know if they sleep, honestly. And without their help, seriously, this would not be occurring right now. And I don't ever take credit for it, but I want to acknowledge all of them, because the credit they deserve, all of them, seriously. They are really amazing. So, thank you all. We're going to start the program, and the first song aptly entitled was called Storm, which seems to be the spring season right now. So it worked out appropriately that I used this material. Please sit back, enjoy the concert. Your children are really wonderful, I just want to let you know that. And we have a big program, you know, in Yorktown of Eastine, and the first letter is empathy. And I can tell you right now that whether, I don't know what they're like at home, but here in school, they are really wonderful. I'm not going to use names, but every once in a while, if a child hurt themselves or they can't carry their books, I see another student going, let me help you. Mr. Getz, can I take blah, blah, blah to the locker because she hurt her leg? Or could I take someone over there because he hurt himself playing? They are really wonderful. And I just want to let you know, in school, your children are really fabulous. So sit back and enjoy the concert.
Thank you.
obviously these are my sixth grade orchestra students, and for my orchestra parents, especially my sixth grade orchestra parents, you'll notice that the material we're playing is substantially longer than they did in fifth grade, and a bit more complicated with the parts are going back and forth and echoing each other. The next song is actually kind of a country piece, and I did that intentionally because it involves some eighth notes and a lot of some plucking at one point that's very, it's difficult, and they do a great job on it. It's called Backcountry Ramble, so sit back and enjoy. From the 1600s by a gentleman named Talis, T-A-L-I-S. And I always tell the students, what does it remind you of? We have some discussions. Now, I don't really watch a lot of TV because I just don't have time for it. But I know there's a big show out there that everyone seems to talk about. We discussed it. I've never watched it, so don't laugh at me. Game of Thrones. I've never seen it. I don't know anything about it. But this piece would be perfect for what little clips I've seen once in a while. For that particular show, because it's kind of, I guess, I'm not even sure what that period is in that show, but I'm thinking medieval times, so this would kind of work in that vein. So sit back and enjoy.
Thank you.
there's a lot of parts moving around. Now, I had talked to all my students, and I was just mentioning, I know some of the some parents, and even when I was, my students, my own children were a little younger, you hear them playing by themselves, and you don't really understand how their parts fit with the other instruments. So just as me being an educator, this has a little education for my parents, just want to just give you an idea. So basses, this is, they didn't expect to do this right now. D7 chord. It's a chord, and on the piano, if you play piano, you would play D, F sharp, A, and C. But what I had them do is just show you as an audience, that is the harmony that's going on within the orchestra. And of course, in full orchestras, New York Philharmonic, which I encourage you to take my students, your children too, they do that all the time. That's kind of the sound you would hear all the time. So when you're playing at home alone, you're not hearing that, but that's what they're working for to create that kind of harmony. Our next song is going Modern Times, a theme song from the movie The Titanic. Chaperones and my 7th grade orchestra, if you could please just go back to the cafeteria. This is our last song for the 6th grade part, and then I'll bring you out. I didn't put it in the program, but I was hoping I could just encourage everyone to please stay for the other orchestras. I always talk to my students about just protocol and manners, and just staying for their colleagues to listen and applaud. I think it's just the proper thing to do. If you can just stay for a little while, we'll be over probably around 7:30, maybe a little earlier. But it really, I like to have my students, especially my younger students, sing the older students, because they always say, Mr. Getz, can you play the song the 8th graders did? Can you play the song the 7th graders did? And so if you can stay, we'd really appreciate it. So I just want to let you know that. Our last song is called Funny Fiddling, and it's a fun piece, and it has a lot of intricate parts. And it's the beginning of my violin section, starting to learn how to play what's called in the 3rd position, which is a very high position, which we start to have all the instruments do. So even though you see the instrument, and you may only see your child playing one area, eventually you want them to play in the whole area of the instrument, whether it be a cello or a viola, a violin, or a bass. and it takes practice and a little more experience. So this is the stepping stone to that next level. So please sit back and enjoy, and then as soon as we're done with this, I'm going to bring them back there, drop their instrument off, and come in here, and then the seventh grade will play. Thank you. We'll be right back in 1 minute.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Nancy Turenti. For those of you who don't know me, I teach from the 8th grade orchestra up through 12th grade here at the high school, and we're so glad to see you here today. 6th graders sound beautiful. Who we have in front of us are 8 of the 8th grade orchestra cellists. Yesterday, in a lesson, we decided that we would play this for you tonight. Part of what we do in all of our music classes and in our performance classes is learn a vocabulary that we can then apply quickly. If you think of it and you equate it to reading a book, every time you open a book, you're not spending 3 months learning the vocabulary, you're using the vocabulary that you've learned from school, from early. And this is the same thing really with music. So these girls are really quite accomplished cellists, and we did this yesterday, and I said, do you want to play this at the concert? And they all said, yeah. So here we have a cello octet of Brahms' First Symphony. And in a second, we'll continue with the 7th grade.
So this is the 7th grade orchestra, and this spring I decided to do a little bit more classical music, and then after the concert we're going to go back to doing maybe a little bit more pop music, which is different rhythms. So we're starting out with a song called Mozart Serenade. So please sit back and enjoy.
Thank you.
show my age here, but we're going to do a piece that obviously has been on a TV show, and then they told me, I didn't realize this, what is the cartoon number? Tom and Jerry. So, which I didn't know that. It's called the William Tell Overture, which everyone has heard before, but it's used on TV, obviously, and cartoons. And I'm trying to just get my students to realize that some music that, and we talked about copyright law, which I know is a little advanced, but we were talking about how older songs that are at least 50 years older or older are no longer protected. So a lot of these composers from, 200 years ago, obviously they're not getting paid anymore. But the songs are used because the producers don't have to pay any royalties for those composers. So I wanted to do a couple of songs. You'll hear one later on. We're doing that's kind of in that vein. So William Tell Overture.
Trying to get them to smile a little bit.
1812 Overture. And most of you know this from actually July 4th, because you'll always hear it playing in the background when the fireworks go on. So we discussed that a little bit, that again, this song, they've heard it many times, but they maybe never realized the name of the song or who the composer was. So I thought it would be a nice idea for them to at least get a small idea of a condensed arrangement of what it sounds like. So again, I'm wishing everyone a great summer, because I know that's coming up in 6 or 7 weeks. Maybe, could be snowing for all we know. But July 4th is about 7 weeks away, so I thought this would be kind of fun for them to play and for my audience to just kind of get a little taste of what the Tchaikovsky sounds like up front. So enjoy. Up and maybe there'll be a real orchestra. I think sometimes in Valhalla at the Kensico Dam, they used to have the New York Philharmonic come up there and play. I don't know if they still do that. Our last piece before the eighth graders come on is called Night Shift. And actually, this involves actually the violas and the cellos and the violins going into, as we discussed before, third position, which is the higher position on the violin, viola, cello, and basses. And it takes a bit more practice. So we're transitioning our students to get a little bit more complicated as they go along. So again, thank you so much. Mrs. Trenti will take over in 1 minute, and your children are just wonderful to teach. So please, encourage them to practice, and take them to see music if you can. It's a wonderful thing, and we live close to one of the epicenters of the arts, New York City. So again, enjoy, and Night Shift.
Thank you. Thank you.